parade of nations. Get that energy up. My name is Nick. Hello. Judging by my outfit, I will be your waiter this evening. I have to say, I love the Philippines. I love it here. Yes. Yes. Give yourselves a round of applause. You're the best fans in the world. In fact, I was doing the math earlier, and without the people in this room, I have 6 Instagram followers. That was a joke, sir. Sorry. No, there are literally tens of millions of Philippine fans, Miss Universe fans. You're the best. And it got me thinking that if you guys were better hackers, there's a pretty good chance that Pia Wurzbach would be president of the United States right now. So, I don't know why that was so controversial. So, here's how tonight's show is going to work. I'm going to call a country's name. They're going to come out in their amazing national costume. I want to hear loud applause for everybody, not just the Philippines and Venezuela and whoever else is going crazy. Let's give them all a nice round of applause. And as a special treat, you will hear a very cheesy rhyme about each contestant as they come out. All right, let's do this thing. Starting with Albania. Vendita's national costume is red and black, representing the colors of the Albanian flag. Life's not a drag when you're dressed as a flag. Albania. Here comes Angola. Angola is covered head to toe in crystals with an elaborate collar and sparkling headpiece. Her national costume represents one of Angola's most important exports, diamonds. Like most diamond mines, she sparkles and shines. Angola! All right, give it up for Argentina! Inspired by Pachamama, a goddess revered by the indigenous people of the Andes Mountains, Argentina's costume represents the creator of the universe. This outfit's bodice was inspired by a goddess, Argentina. Aruba. Aruba hosted the 30th annual Aruba High Winds competition last year, which is an international windsurfing and kiteboarding tournament. To honor that event, her national costume was inspired by the sport of windsurfing. Get off her turf if you don't windsurf, Aruba! Australia! percentage of her nation's coral reefs are dying due to global warming, Australia wanted to use her national costume to raise awareness of the issue. Her ruffled skirt represents the oceans, while the hues of her costume are inspired by the colors of a healthy reef ecosystem. A coral reef inspired this costume's motif, Australia. Austria! Austria's national costume was inspired by The Sound of Music, which is set in Salzburg. The musical is a well-known representation of her country. The hills are alive, making this costume thrive, Austria. Bahamas. Depicting the coat of arms of the Bahamas, this costume comprised of three of her country's national symbols: the flamingo, the blue marlin, and the yellow elder. There isn't any harm showing off your coat of arms, like Bahamas. Barbados. A depiction of Barbados' most visited tourist attraction, Shannon's costume represents Harrison's Cave, a crystallized limestone cavern which was discovered in 1795 but forgotten for nearly 200 years. She says the outfit weighs more than 15 pounds and took several months to create. She's feeling brave, so she dressed up like a cave, Barbados. Belgium! Stephanie didn't know what her national costume would be until her final fitting, which took place right before she left for Manila. The colors, red, black, and yellow, are meant to symbolize the Belgian flag. She's got a knack for rocking red, yellow, and black. It's Belgium! Belize. The scarlet macaw is a beautiful bird in Belize that is, unfortunately, a target of poachers. Rebecca chose the bird as inspiration for her national costume. In fact, she even assisted in the costume's creation and says the wings are so large they had to be shipped to Manila in their own box. Enormous wings are her favorite things. Belize. Bolivia! Bolivia's national costume is based on a folk festival. It represents 18 different folkloric dances that are performed throughout her country. If you like to folk dance, give this contestant a chance, Bolivia! Brazil! Because natural beauty is Brazil's favorite aspect of her country, she wanted her national costume to transform her into a goddess of nature. The design features feathers and fish-like scales. Not sure if you've heard, she's part fish and part bird, Brazil! British Virgin Islands. Representing the sun, sea, and sand, this costume was handmade for British Virgin Islands and features actual seashells from her country's beaches, as well as faux coral and floral details. For fans of sun, sea, and sand, this costume is grand. British Virgin Islands. Bulgaria. Bulgaria's national costume was designed by a student at the National Art Academy of Bulgaria. The designer was inspired by a traditional festival known by some as the Bulgarian Halloween. The bells are meant to scare away evil spirits. This beauty queen likes to rep Halloween, Bulgaria. Canada. Combining a number of different national icons and symbols, Canada's costume features the iconic maple leaf from her country's flag. The large snowflake includes the shape of every Canadian province and territory, and the ensemble is topped off with a hat and mittens. If you like the cold, this costume never gets old. Canada! Cayman Islands. Created by a designer from the Cayman Islands, Monique's costume represents the clear and pristine waters of her country. It features a full blue skirt covered in rhinestones. Nothing is hotter than a girl dressed as water, Cayman Islands. Chile. Inspired by a legend from the south of Chile, where Catalina's family is from, this costume is meant to depict two sea creatures that form the country's southern islands. Catalina says the costume is so heavy that she can barely move in it. This costume's so heavy, it weighs as much as a Chevy, Chile. China. China's national costume features images of panda bears, which are her absolute favorite. The design also includes a bamboo umbrella and is intended to honor the Chinese tradition of bestowing pandas as gifts to other nations. Forget all the propaganda. She loves a good panda. It's China. Colombia! The skirt of Colombia's national costume was made using techniques from the indigenous people of her country. The top includes traditional Colombian beadwork. Looks like she needs to be covered in beads, Colombia! Special shout out to the yacht that just went by. Costa Rica! Conveying a message of environmental conservation, this costume is 100% recycled. It features a skirt made of repurposed fabrics and flowers created using reused aluminum. Don't get it confused, it's recycled, not used. Costa Rica! Croatia! Croatia is wearing a modified version of traditional Croatian attire. The design merges two different styles and features a short ballerina-style skirt, puffy sleeves, and a red scarf. She won't take a vacation from dressing Croatian. It's Croatia! Curaçao! Curaçao is dressed to represent her favorite bird, which is found throughout the Caribbean islands. It has distinctive black, white, and yellow plumage. Bird is the word for Curaçao! Czech Republic. Czech Republic's national costume is embellished with flowers that were handmade by students at a primary school east of Prague. The gown will be sold after the pageant, and the proceeds will be donated to that special needs school. Covered in flowers, this dress empowers Czech Republic. Denmark! Christina's national costume was created by a Danish designer who was inspired by the fairy tales of Denmark's own Hans Christian Andersen. It took the designer 180 hours to attach the crystals. You have to admire the way fairy tales did inspire Denmark. Dominican Republic. Honoring a Dominican painter who was from the same area where she comes from, Dominican Republic's national costume was inspired by one of his famous works. She loves that it's very colorful and depicts art by someone from her home province. The love of art sets this costume apart, Dominican Republic. Whoa. Beautiful save by the bird lady. Ecuador is known as the land of the hummingbirds and boasts a total of 124 different species. Connie's national costume was inspired by the multitude of differently colored hummingbirds that call her country home. It's absurd not to dress like a bird when you're Ecuador. There are a lot of birds tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Finland! Finnish people believe that Santa Claus lives in the northernmost region of Finland. Children from all over the world sent letters there, hoping to reach Father Christmas. Shirley's national costume honors that belief by featuring a Christmas theme. If you like St. Nick, this contestant's your pick, Finland. France! Wow. France's red feather costume is an authentic garment from the world-famous cabaret, the Moulin Rouge in Paris. In fact, this is one of the only times that an official Moulin Rouge costume has ever traveled outside of France to be worn by someone other than a Moulin Rouge dancer. If you like a dancer, this girl's your answer, France. Georgia. Georgia's national costume, in addition to tripping her, was made by the same designer responsible for her competition evening gown. The inspiration for the costume came from traditional dresses that have been worn by Georgian women for centuries. Made by hand, it comes from her land, Georgia. Germany. Because fairy tales have played an important role in her life, Johanna chose a national costume inspired by Brothers Grimm from Germany. The costume features a castle-like headpiece, a pop-up storybook, and LED lights sewn into the gown. Wearing a hat like a castle is never a hassle when you're Germany. Great Britain! Great Britain's national costume depicts the goddess of the ocean. As a certified scuba diver, Jamie Lee thought this was fitting and symbolic choice to represent both herself and her country. When you're the queen of the ocean, you'll cause a commotion like Great Britain. Guam. At our national competition, Guam's costume was nearly 9 feet tall and 5 feet wide. Her Miss Universe costume, however, is a little smaller and lighter. The design was inspired by shells from her island. She'll put you under her spell with her gigantic shell. It's Guam. Guyana. This national costume was inspired by a painting that was exhibited at the Guyana Coconut Festival last year. She's meant to be a character from the painting known as the Coconut Queen. Playing the part of a great work of art, Guyana. Haiti. Raquel's costume features a large headpiece and is intended to depict the natural beauty of her home country of Haiti, which is known by many as the Pearl of the Antilles. Looking for a pearl? Then this is your girl, Haiti! Honduras! The national flower of Honduras is the angel orchid. This flower was the inspiration behind Honduras' national costume, which displays beauty, vigor, and distinction. Her national flower represents power, Honduras. Hungary. Featuring traditional Hungarian embroidery, Hungary's national costume is adorned with 1,500 of the red peppers that are used to make paprika. She looks awfully nice, representing a spice, Hungary. Iceland. Because Iceland is known as the land of fire and ice, her national costume is a conceptual representation of those two elements. She's inspired by nature, half volcano, half glacier. It's Iceland. India. This represents a colorful and dynamic form of traditional Indian theater that combines dance, music, and elaborate outfits. It's hard not to squeal when you see a big golden wheel like India. Indonesia! The inspiration for Indonesia's national costume is a large bird-like creature from both Hindu and Buddhist mythology. Everyone's a fan of her golden wingspan, Indonesia. Israel. Israel's national costume is based on the biblical character of Eve. Before leaving for Manila, Israel did a photo shoot in the costume with a real snake. You best believe she's inspired by Eve, Israel. Italy. Referencing the Neapolitan Carnival and fashions worn by the royal court, Italy's national costume is a green velvet dress with rich gold embellishments. We're proud to report to her royal court, it's Italy. Jamaica. The design of Jamaica's costume honors a group of people who populated the Greater Antilles. It features a huge headpiece, loincloth and tail, and is covered in feathers. All hail her feathery tail, it's Jamaica. Japan. Created by fusing a traditional kimono with a modern dress, Japan's national costume was inspired by an ocean wave and uses a traditional Japanese color palette of red, white, black, and gold. Inspired by the notion of a multicolored ocean, Japan. Kazakhstan. This national costume features colors matching those of the Kazakhstan flag, while the delicate hand embroidery references traditional designs. She's looking fine in a Kazakh design. It's Kazakhstan. Kenya. Kenya is proud to be wearing a creation from one of her country's leading fashion designers who was inspired by artistry from different Kenyan communities. She's filled with elation to be repping her nation, Kenya. Korea. Jennie's national costume is a garment traditionally worn by Korean queens during festivals. She says this particular outfit is meant to bring the wearer health and wealth, and maybe the universe crown. She's on a mission to honor tradition, Korea. Kosovo. Kosovo is wearing a traditional black and white full costume from her country. Tonight's the night to wear black and white for Kosovo. Malaysia. The Petronas Towers, which hold the distinction of being the tallest twin towers in the world, were the inspiration behind Malaysia's national costume. This girl likes shoulders with spikes, it's Malaysia. Ooh, that one got an air horn. Malta. Malta's national costume was created by her country's most successful carnival designer. Even though it's large, she got special permission from the airline to bring the headdress onto her flight as a carry-on. This large headdress is sure to impress. It's Malta. Mauritius. Oh wait, never mind, that is Mexico. My bad. Her costume represents her home. The garment, complete with hat and boots, is traditionally made from leather and features floral details and long fringe sleeves. This outfit hinges on traditional fringes, Mexico. Uh-oh. we got coming out now. Let's make some noise. That looks heavy. I'd help her, but I'm way too weak. Here she is. It is Myanmar. Created by the same designer who made her competition evening gown, Myanmar's costume was inspired by a traditional puppet dance from her country. I guess that's her thing, to dance on a string. It's Myanmar. I'm pretty sure I saw that once in an NSYNC video. Namibia! Dubbed the Desert Queen, Lizelle's costume symbolizes two things Namibia is known for: diamonds and the Namibian desert. Let's give her a hand, because she's inspired by sand, Namibia! Netherlands is wearing a costume inspired by Dutch water management. While the skirt represents water, the focal point is a windmill with blades that are supposed to rotate and kind of do. Oh, there they go. It's a thrill to be dressed like a mill when you're Netherlands. All right, folks, looks like something's happening, something's brewing over there. We got something big coming for you. Are you guys excited for the telecast? Yeah? Steve Harvey is making his return? Yes! Give it up! We have Ashley Graham backstage. You guys Boyz II Men fans? Flo Rida, give it up for Flo Rida. All right, we're coming back at you with Mauritius. This costume features a cape meant to represent the volcanic explosion responsible for the formation of her island. It was created by a Filipino designer and is hand-painted by children from a local orphanage in the Philippines. Give her a cheer, because this dress was made here. It's Mauritius. All right, don't mind if I do, Mauritius. I'm gonna take this thing. Yes. I need to get myself a national costume now. All right, who's stepping up here? New Zealand! Depicting the Earth Mother goddess who gives birth to all things, New Zealand's costume features a cape that represents the land and spiral patterns that represent new life. There isn't another who could pull off the Earth Mother like New Zealand. Nicaragua! This national costume represents Nicaragua's national bird. Known for its colorful plumage, the bird can be found throughout her country. The costume here weighs more than 20 pounds. She can light up a room with her colorful plume, Nicaragua! Nigeria! Nigeria! Representing the native people of West Africa, Nigeria's national costume is a ceremonial garment. She says her favorite part is the beaded headpiece. She's dressed in all red with beads on her head, Nigeria. Norway. Created by a Norwegian design student, Norway's costume was inspired by the ice, ocean, snow, and mountains of her country. She says it reminds her of Elsa's gown from the movie Frozen. Repping her region, this costume's oh so Norwegian, Norway. Panama. Panama's national costume was inspired by a traditional market in a small town where locals and visitors from all over the world can purchase flowers and coffee grown in Panama's Green Mountain Highlands. She's purple and green with flowers in between. It's Panama. Paraguay. Comprised of more than 2,000 pieces of traditional handmade lace, Paraguay's costume, which was painted by hand, by the way, depicts one of her country's national symbols, the passion flower. Looking grand because she's painted by hand, it's Paraguay. Peru! Peru's national costume was made by hearing impaired artisans who live in the Peruvian jungle. Created using sustainable materials and natural items such as rice and pieces of maize. She didn't think twice about wearing corn and rice. It's Peru! You guys ready for the next one? Then let's bring out Philippines! Philippines' national costume wasn't completed until just recently. It was inspired by traditional Vinta boats and features a headpiece designed to resemble a large piece of coral from a Filipino reef. You won't hear this rhyme, so I won't waste my time. It's Philippines! Poland! This national costume was created by a Polish designer. The garment is a long, white dress with handmade flowers, and the hat is indicative of traditional attire from the northern region of her country. Designed by Poles, this outfit is hashtag goals. Poland! Portugal! Portugal's national costume is inspired by the Wall of Hope, which honors Portuguese culture and cultivation of flowers. As part of the festival, children built a gigantic wall of flowers that symbolizes hope. She's having a ball with flowers on a wall. It's Portugal. Puerto Rico. Inspired by Puerto Rico's coat of arms, Brenda's national costume honors St. John the Baptist, which was the name Christopher Columbus gave her island in 1493. I bet St. John would definitely fawn over Puerto Rico. Romania. This national costume is reminiscent of the garments worn by Romanian women during the 1920s and 30s. It's been a while since you've seen this style. Romania. Russia. Depicting a bird of peace from a Russian fairy tale, this national costume is adorned with pearls, crystals, and feathers. Looking fine in her bird-like design, it's Russia. Let's hear it for Sierra Leone. This national costume is decorated with seashells and beads that are common in Sierra Leone. The design was inspired by garments traditionally worn by African dancers. Inspired by tradition, this girl's on a mission. It's Sierra Leone. Singapore. Inspired by the wedding garments worn by people of her country, Singapore's national costume has intricate embroidery and beadwork. She wanted to choose a costume fit for I do's. It's Singapore. Slovak Republic. This blue and white garment being worn by Slovak Republic is a dress traditionally worn by folk dancers in her country. This isn't a joke, she's all about folk. Slovak Republic. Slovenia. This national costume is a hand-woven silk dress with a print inspired by Slovenian lace. You've come to the right place if you're looking for lace. Slovenia. South Africa. South Africa says she loves her national costume because it captures the Swazi culture and showcases her heritage. The headpiece is meant to represent her birthplace, the place of the rising sun. She's having fun in the rising sun in South Africa. Spain. This national costume was inspired by the letter Ñe, which is unique to the Spanish language. It was originally much larger, but the back piece was too big to fit on her airplane here. No one's looked better representing a letter than Spain. Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka's national costume represents traditional clothing from her country. It's a white two-piece outfit with a blouse and sari that features pleating at the shoulder. This contestant's on fire in traditional attire, Sri Lanka. Sweden. This national costume honors the character Pippi Longstocking, who was created by Swedish author Astrid Lindgren. She wore the same dress as her evening gown earlier tonight. You can just add a horse, and there's your costume, of course. It's Sweden. Come on, Sweden, ride that puppy out of here. All right, we've got Switzerland. Decorated with traditional embroidery from a town in Switzerland, this costume includes a Swiss headdress and flowers found throughout the Alpine region. You don't want to miss a costume from this Swiss, Switzerland. Tanzania. Created by a Tanzanian designer, this costume honors the natural resources of her country and is printed with pictures of elephants and other wildlife. The entire garment was made using recycled bottles and cans. She takes great pleasure turning trash into treasure. Tanzania. Thailand. The muse behind Thailand's national costume was Queen Sirikit. The garment, based on fashions worn by the queen, is embellished with thousands of crystals. Fresh on the scene, she's dressed like a queen. Thailand. Turkey. This costume draws inspiration from ancient statues found atop a mountain site in southeastern Turkey. It is believed to be a royal tomb from the first century BC. Please make some room, because she's dressed like a tomb. It's Turkey. Ukraine. Entitled Blooming Ukraine, this costume is a reflection of how she sees her country. Fun, cheery, and peaceful. The design is a fusion of various national styles from regions within Ukraine. The finals are looming, but this beauty's blooming. It's Ukraine. Uruguay. This costume symbolizes the national flower of Uruguay. It weighs more than 30 pounds and had to be disassembled so it could be shipped here to the Philippines. Lifting this flower takes a lot of manpower. Uruguay. Let me snag that for my scrapbook. For bringing out USA! Representing the strength of women, USA's national costume takes on a superhero theme. Deshauna says she feels like a warrior when she puts it on. Up, up, and away, it's USA! Nailed it. U.S. Virgin Islands. This costume honors Transfer Day, when U.S. Virgin Islands became a territory of the United States. It measures roughly 10 feet wide and is adorned with crystals, flowers, and a seashell, I can't say that, inspired headpiece. The costume's wide, but she wears it with pride. U.S. Virgin Islands. All right, let's hear it for Venezuela. This costume was inspired by a tribe that traded pearls with Christopher Columbus. The design represents a mythical mermaid who possessed great beauty. In 1492, Columbus would have been less blue if he had Venezuela. Just a reminder to those of you watching at home to tune into the Red Carpet Show, Sunday, January 29th from 6 to 7 p.m. Eastern Time. All right, let's continue the show with Vietnam. Vietnam had 5 designers submit ideas for her national costume, and she selected this unique design. It's comprised of a staff, headpiece, skirt, boots, and 3D backpiece. Looking fine in a unique design, it's Vietnam. Well, what'd you guys think? Who was your favorite? Well, this is the embarrassing part of the show when I realize I never actually wrote an ending. So I will just say that I love this country. Everybody here is having a blast. We are so happy you welcome the entire Miss Universe organization here. We've never felt more welcome. I want to move here, but I just found out you need a visa, apparently. You've got to get married is the only way you can. Is anyone here willing to marry me tonight? All right. I heard 3 dudes over there. I'll take that. That's good enough. Everybody, have a good night.